moving along to the tear tree, we have it a bit easier, since the tiered branches indicate where the rows of garlands should be placed, and the main branches mark the peaks. I'm using silver garland on this tree. Work from bottom to top as with the panel tree. I plan to decorate this tree in a traditional glass theme, so I felt some multicolored bead chain would be a nice accompaniment to the silver garland and tie in nicely with the glass ornaments. Bead chain is just that, a long garland made of colored beads. I purposely skipped every other row with the silver garland, and I filled in by draping bead chain on those peaks. I've put a traditional glass top on this tree. Now, of course, this is the most basic way to drape garland on a tree, but I'll show you a few variations as well in case you're feeling confident enough to experiment a bit. Here we have a diagonal drape that goes around the tree in a sort of corkscrew design. Here we've done a zigzag design down the sides of the tree, from top to bottom. Here we've alternated peaks with two strands of garland, just as we did with the silver garland and the bead chain. Here we've done a crisscross effect, mixing the basic drape with a vertical drape. These are just a few of the various effects you can achieve by experimenting with the drape of the garland. If you use your imagination, I'm sure you can come up with many more variations. And of course, you're not limited to using packaged garland. These designs can be employed when using popcorn and cranberry garland, or construction paper garland as well. Now, I decided to decorate the live tree with old-fashioned wood and fabric ornaments. So I thought it might be nice to use ribbon as garland on this tree to give it a bit of a country look. Many craft supply houses sell rolls of ribbon, and it is also readily available and most trim a tree departments at Christmas time. The principle is the same as with the tinsel garland, except that you must secure each peak with a small piece of wire so that it stays put. Drape the garland from peak to peak, as with the tinsel garland, giving it a few twists between each peak to give it a more interesting look. Finish off each peak with a small bow made from the same ribbon. These can be bought ready-made. Then top the tree off with a large matching bow. There. Now all three trees have their garland and are ready for ornaments. This is the easy part. There are only a couple of basic rules. Larger ornaments should be hung at the peaks, with smaller ornaments used to fill in. Also, larger ornaments should be hung lower on the tree, decreasing in size as you work up the tree, with the smallest ornaments near the top. This will result in a more properly balanced look. On the red and white tree, I start by clustering one red and one white satin ball by hooking them together, like so, and hanging the clusters at the peaks. You see, you don't have to hang Christmas balls individually. Hanging them in clusters of two, three, or even more can produce very interesting effects. Experiment with different sizes and colors of ornaments to see what combinations work on your tree. I've filled in with various kinds of red and white novelty ornaments, hanging the larger ones near the bottom and working up the tree as the ornaments decrease in size. Another tip is to hang single balls in near the base of the branches so that they reflect the light and add depth to the tree. I've used the same basic principle to hang the traditional glass ornaments on the tear tree, larger ones at the peaks and near the bottom, decreasing in size as we work up the tree, and making sure to hang some ornaments in near the center of the tree to reflect the lights. The same goes for the old-fashioned ornaments on our country tree. For this tree, however, I filled it out a bit with some dried flowers, white baby's breath in this case, though you could use any type you think will complement your color scheme. Dried flowers are easily obtainable at most garden centers and craft shops. Here we've finished off each tree with a coordinated tree skirt. Let's quickly review the basic steps I've shown you up to this point. Be sure to select a full, freshly cut tree and water it regularly. Consider buying an artificial tree if your holiday plans include some time away from home. Be sure it's properly shaped before you begin lighting. Always work with the lights plugged in so you can see what you're doing. Wrap the lights around the branches in order to hide the wires. Begin lighting at the top, working your way down the tree one layer of branches at a time. Try weaving in a few sets of lights in a contrasting color, or maybe even some twinkling lights for a special effect. Drape garland from peak to peak, one layer of branches at a time. Work from bottom to top, making sure the rows of garland are evenly spaced. Think about using fabric bows in a contrasting color on the peaks, or alternating with strands of bead chain in a color that will complement your theme. Ribbon also makes a beautiful garland. Fasten the peaks with floral wire and finish them off with a matching bow. Experiment with the drape of your garland until you find a variation that pleases you and works with your decorating scheme. Hang larger ornaments lower on the tree and at the peaks. Smaller ornaments should be used to fill in, with the smallest ones near the top. Try clustering balls together for an interesting look, and be sure to hang ornaments in near the center of the tree to reflect the lights. Consider using dried or silk flowers in a coordinated color to give your tree a fuller look and a contrasting texture. Use a specially made skirt to hide the tree stand. And finish off your tree with a coordinated tree top. And there you have it. Our three trees are completely decorated. But wait, there's more. For the more adventurous among you, I'll take you on a little guided tour through a whole grove of handsomely decorated trees, pointing out the different ideas and techniques that went into the creation of each one. You may want to copy the designs as you see them, or simply use the ideas as a point of departure for creating your own original theme. The only limits to the variations that are possible are the materials you have available to you and your own imagination. Our first tree is decorated with a music theme. Instruments of brass and wood, sheet music, and fans are all incorporated into the red, white, and gold color scheme. The garland was made especially for this tree by twisting strands of red and gold bead chain together into a single rope. Red glass balls with a gold star pattern are used to fill in. Our next tree is done in a silver and ice theme. Wide silver ribbon resembling aluminum foil was draped on the tree in a corkscrew pattern. Ice blue silk flowers were used to fill in, along with small bouquets of pine cones, packages, and silver berries. And ornaments of frosted glass were chosen to complement the white frost balls at the peaks. The next two trees have a more sophisticated look, this one being a silver theme with pink highlights. Silver garland and bead chain icicles are accented with pink silk flowers, package clusters, mirrored ornaments, and silver novelty ornaments.